different types of front headlocks, but I'm gonna give you the most basic front headlock and what you need to have. And with the front headlock, we can control, we can transition in this position, when he's in the parterre position or turtle, we can transition to go behind, take his back, or we can transition to submission. Today, we're just gonna learn the basics of the front headlock and get an intro from our feet. So, the front headlock has 3 points of control. You have to control the what? Chin. I have to have control the back of his neck and control the elbow. So we can control it like this, or you can actually get it in here and pull up. Pull back a little bit. This takes a lot away, because the farther away his elbow is from his body, the less power he has. When it's in here, it's really strong. So from this position here, I'm controlling this, the chin, and here. And notice, my shoulder's at a what? It's in an angle. You know why I have it at an angle? Begin to circle, ready? You should stop solving. Circle. Go to your left. Go to your left. So, if I'm on my knee, I can constantly circle with him, as opposed to, who's seen guys do a front headlock like this? You begin to circle. Now, he might beat me, turn the corner, and take me down. So one more time on your knee. So the 3 points are chin, back of his neck, and elbow. So I grab the chin, I'm on a knee, foot out, his head's pushed down by my body, and we cup it right here. So let's go to the standing. So this is our drill today we're going to do. We're going to bring him down in the tie-up position. Remember those little snap downs we did? How we just kind of popped? So today we're going to do one motion today instead of doing three. That was just exaggerated. So I just take a step here, elbow in, I pull down, and I go to a what? I go to the chin. And I go to the what? The elbow, and I bring him down. So now, controlling the chin, the what? The back of his neck, and pull it out a little bit, guys. Pull it out, because the closer it is to here, he has more power. Pull it out, or you can even do this right here. This is a good one, because it sits up in a nice rondo. You got to develop a right and a left-handed front headlock. Who has it? We can do both. Who's limited to just like one? I can do a right. Okay, so practice both. Back up again. So we're just gonna do this. Assuming you're right-handed. Tie up, inside control. Pretty much, if you have the inside control on the ground, standing, you're in a dominant position. So I just shuffle my feet to the side, push it down. Anytime your opponent's head is at the level of your armpit or below, you can go into a what? For headlock. Put it out. If I am in here and I step in, I can do what? I can do the front headlock. Why? Below my armpit. There's a lot of butterfly attacks where you're coming in and you can go to the front headlock series, which is pretty good. Back up again. So we're gonna just tie up here. I'm gonna shuffle like this, and I'm gonna pull down. Head is where? Armpit. Front headlock. I grab the chin. This is the most important thing. Grab the chin, pop it, bring it down, and now turn. I'm on my what? A knee, shoulder, and here, because if he begins to turn, other way. Keep going. I can go